Nuclear official says Hillary Clinton engaged in extortion, secret FBI informant is set to blow open Uranium One scandal, video. According to Clinton Cash, author Peter Schweizer, then Senator Hillary Clinton extorted a Kazakh official involved in the Uranium One deal. It is possible Schweizer misspoke and meant to say Secretary of State Clinton. The Breitbart News editor-at-large did not go further into detail, merely alluding to the fact that the secret FBI informant's testimony on the Uranium One scandal next week will be very interesting. Transcript via Grabian. Schweizer: well, I have to say up front, I have not met him. I don't know him. But, what I understand by looking at legal documents involving this case. This guy was an insider's insider. He was being paid by the Russian company $50,000 a month to serve as a lobbyist. And in the legal filings, what you find is his job was to basically carry the flag for this entity in Washington, D.C., and that job included setting up meetings with high-ranking administration officials. This would have been the Obama administration. People on Capitol Hill. And other elite influence, you know, makers. So, he was working in a very, very high level. And what has leaked out seems to indicate he has got a lot of information that relates specifically to Uranium One. So, it's going to be very exciting, and I think it's important to point out, Judge, also, remember, we already have a foreign government official saying that involving Uranium One that he and his fellow government employees were extorted by the Clintons' then-Senator Hillary Clinton. This comes from the head of their atomic agency saying that Senator Clinton refused to meet with officials unless and until they granted uranium concessions to ended up giving more than $100 million to the Clinton Foundation. So we have got the testimony. We have got this new witness coming out. It's going to get very interesting here in the weeks ahead. William D. Campbell has come forward as the secret FBI informant in the Uranium One deal. The informant revealed he is eager to testify because of his concerns about Russia's activities in the United States, but declined to comment further, reports Reuters. I have worked with the Justice Department undercover for several of years, and documentation relating to Uranium One and political influence does exist, and I have it, Campbell told Reuters. According to a report by Andrea Noble, Campbell personally bribed a Russian businessman working for state-owned energy giant Rosatom. The informant then attempted to recoup the money, but failed. Washington Times reports. A FBI informant who gave the government information about a Russian bribery plot implicated in the sale of U.S. uranium rights tried unsuccessfully last year to recover upwards of $700,000 in bribes he said he was authorized to pay as part of the FBI investigation. William D. Campbell has emerged now as the key figure in a congressional probe into Russia's 2010 purchase of U.S. uranium rights and then-Secretary of State Hillary Clinton's role in approving the deal. His identity had been shielded for weeks, but court records obtained by the Washington Times, as well as a report by Reuters, identified the man. Mr. Campbell has not returned calls from the Washington Times seeking comment, but his civil suit, describing his involvement in the FBI investigation, mashes details of the criminal case brought against Vadim Mikhrin. Mikhrin, who was the head of U.S. operations for 10X, a subsidiary of Russia's atomic energy giant Rosatom, was convicted of money laundering and other crimes and in 2015 sentenced to 4 years in prison. As the Gateway pundit's Jim Hoft reported on Thursday evening, investigative reporter John Solomon told Sean Hannity that the Campbell has video of briefcases full of money in the bribery of case on Hillary Clinton. Solomon says the Reuters report today downplaying the informant is completely inaccurate. The informant says he is in fear for his life since he was outed by the Sessions DOJ. Campbell will reportedly testify on Monday. The informant will testify next week before Congress.